When you go and pastor and talk to me, the Lord that God says, I will hear your prayer. Hear and understand.
Come on, pal.
Talk to him while he is near.
Yeah.
While he calls. When he's trying to cry out to you and tell you to stop. When he tell you to stop. When he tell you to go left. When he tell you to go right. Hear from your spirit. The Holy Spirit is talking to your spirit. Ezekiel 4, verse, chapter 4, verse 4 through 8.
Then lie down on your left side.
Wait a minute. The Holy Spirit told Ezekiel, the prophet, my God, he spoke to his spirit, human spirit, and he told him to do what?
Lie down on your left side.
Oh, Lord, have mercy, boy. I tell you, I didn't want to do this, but I'm having to demonstrate it now. The Bible told the man of God, Ezekiel, to do what?
Lie down on your left side.
Am I on my left side? I'm on my left side, right?
Yeah.
Read.
And I will place on you the gift of the nation of Israel.
My Lord.
Keep reading.
For 390 days, you will stay there and suffer because of their guilt.
Hold it right there. It's already starting to hurt. I'm laying on my ribs. God, the Holy Ghost, spoke to the man of God. You already know this was in the Bible, huh? He spoke to Ezekiel the prophet. And he told him, I want you to demonstrate how I really feel. Because my people are disobedient to me. And they won't take heed to my word. I want you to lay down on your left side for 390 days. For a whole year and 15 more days. And you're going to find out later on in the Bible that the Bible said that God had it tied up where he couldn't turn. He had to stay on his left side. Y'all ain't listening to the word of the living God. Read.
He said, I have sentenced you to one day for each year that punishment will last. When you finish that, turn over on your right side.
390 days he stayed on his left side and you can't move. He told them that to do that from the children of Israel. They had two sisters, children of Israel and children of Judah. Mm-hmm. Church folk. Come on, somebody. One wouldn't learn from the other. Mm-hmm. If you're going to have a friend, you ought to have a friend that's going to tell you the truth.
Yeah.
If I'm going to have a friend, I don't need you to agree with me in my own room. That ain't no true friend. A true friend will tell you about yourself. A true friend will tell you you're going wrong, girl. You ain't doing it right. Whether you want to hear it or not, the birds of a feather flock together. That means you deal with somebody who agrees with what you do. You don't need that in your life. After the Bible says he lay on the left side 390 days, you know what?
Turn over on your right side.
And how many days you say that?
And then I will suffer that you may suffer for the guilt of Judah for 40 days.
For 40 days.
One day for each year of their punishment. Fix your eyes on the siege of Jerusalem.
He told him, look at the people. Look at what they're going through. Because they won't be obedient to that. What did he say?
Shake your fist at the city and prophesy against
them. He said, look at them. Shake your fist at them. Let the people see it. Y'all ain't listening to the preacher. All the children of Israel was looking at the man of God laying down on his side. And they wondering like you looking at me now. What in the world is going on? God said, shake your fist at them. Let them know this is how I feel when you disobey me. And continue to disobey me. And don't care no more. This hurts. He wanted Ezekiel to feel the pain. When you lay on your rear. For 390 seconds, let alone 390 days. Because he made us. And he made us to worship him.
Almighty
God. Did you finish that?
No.
I will tie you up so that you cannot turn from one side to the other until the siege is over.
To the siege, I mean until the enemy finished surrounding them. Okay, what had happened was the enemy surrounded the city just like the enemy wants to surround you. Now, what happened? They call that a siege. A siege means that now, whenever y'all run out of water and food, you can't go run to hide neighbors and go get no more. Because the enemy is surrounded by your house, you're going to run out of food after a while. You're going to run out of water soon. You're going to run out of juice. You're going to run out of things. Come on, somebody. If somebody take a siege, see, the enemy want to siege your soul. Who has your soul got you? Which profit a man to gain whole world and lose his? But the soul want to do what he want to do. Let me go to Genesis 1. I got to keep moving. My time running. Genesis 1, verse 1 and 2. The first of the book, first two verses in the whole Bible. The Bible says from the King James Version, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth was without form and void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. And the, oh, there we go. And the what?
Spirit of God.
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 Moved upon the face of the waters. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. He made the heaven and earth out of nothing. That word created me. From nothing, God made it.
Yes.
And then the Bible said, and the earth was. The word was in the Hebrew should be became. That's reading again according to the Hebrew. And the earth became without form.
Yes.
Whatever God made, he didn't make nothing void and empty. Mm. What God created was good.
Yes.
But something happened.
Well.
According to God, thank you. To the captivity, to what I believe. Something happened between verse 1 and verse 2. What happened is Satan got kicked out of heaven. There was war in heaven. Michael and the archangel had a fight because Satan said, I want to be like God. Woo! Isaiah the prophet and Jeremiah told me, my God Almighty, that Lucifer, what was his name?
Yeah.
He became Satan and the devil after God kicked him out.
Yeah.
Why? He wanted to be like God.
Yeah. Yeah.
So the Bible said when God kicked him out of heaven, he came down on the earth. And back in those days, the earth was covered with water. And all the land was together. But you couldn't see the land because it was covered by water. And waves, huge waves. And the earth, the Bible said, was dark. Because of Satan. And the next verse I tell me, and God said, let there be light.
Yeah.
Why did he say, let there be light?
Yeah.
Because it was dark.
Yeah.
The Holy Ghost, I'm, he said in the Spirit of God, moved.
Yeah.
The word moved in the Hebrew means hovered. That means hovered right above the water. The Spirit of God never stopped moving, hovering over the waters that covered the mountains, covered everything. But the Spirit never stopped moving. The Spirit said, I'm going to move until God give me the direction to shake up some things. I'm
going
to move until I tell the waters to recede. I'm going to move. See, something about the Holy Spirit is always moving. Somebody say, move. It never sits still. The earth is always. Whatever God does, the creation is always. In Alaska right now, for 6 months, there's a certain city that won't see the sun for 6 months. Because it's right on the top of the North Pole where the earth tilts. The earth is not straight up. The earth is tilted on a degree and turning on the tilt. And therefore, the city of Alaska, they don't see a sun right now. They ain't going to see it for 6 months. I'm talking about the power of God.
Yeah.
hovering over us. Because it's careful. And it's concerned about us. It never stopped moving in your heart. It never stopped telling you to stop. Start. Do the right thing. Don't do the wrong thing. It never stopped what? When you want to lie, can't you tell the truth? It's always moving on. Where is it moving at? It's moving upon your spirit. It's communicating with your spirit. Because it can't communicate to your soul. It can't communicate to your flesh. It must communicate to your human spirit. I am a spirit. I possess a soul. And I just so happen to live in a body. And we all different colors. All different shades. All different sizes. That don't matter. The real you is on the inside. Give a word of the Lord. The real you is on the inside. Woo, hallelujah. The problem with the church, the problem with believers and unbelievers alike. Nobody never tells about the three parts of man and how they relate and how they separate. I don't know who I am, and here I am 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 years old. When you are there. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Move. What is this that makes me want to do right? It is called the Holy Ghost. It is called the Holy Spirit. Moving upon my spirit. Ooh, hallelujah. That was a secular entertainer. Made some powerful music. Somewhere along him making the music pop, he got born again.
Yeah.
Got saved.
Yeah.
The human spirit joined with the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
And he accepted Jesus as his personal Savior.
Yeah.
That's what happened with these two right here.
Yeah.
And you come back to where you're supposed to be. Yeah. After a song, a gig, he got on the bus to go to the next gig. And he got his Bible, opened his Bible up, and he snorted some cocaine.
Come on.
Now remember, he was born again.
Come on.
He got the cocaine, got his Bible, sniffed the cocaine from his Bible, and then read the same Bible that said, God loves me. Hear the words of the Lord and understand. That same brother became a pastor. And for over 20 years, he had problems and issues with drugs. How then can a man or a woman who is born again still have problems in the body? If you're with me, you understand that you can't condemn nobody your own self. Because you got issues. I got issues. I got problems still. And I'm behind the pulpit. Ha. For 20 years, the man of God seemed to have problems in the flesh. Every night he did, he felt like he needed to go get a hit. Why wasn't he delivered at the time? It's because he had not learned how to see God, see himself as God sees him.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Come on.
All of us is dealing with self right now.
Amen.
You say,
yeah.
You born again.
Yeah.
Well, why are you still doing what you do? Because you need somebody to teach you and help you understand. God's got deliverance for you, but you've got to be ready to hear and listen. Because the Spirit of God is hovering over your heart. And he's telling you, come to me. Why are you, Jesus? David said, why are you coming when I need you? God said, I'm here all the time, son. I'm hovering over your heart like I hover over the water. And he told the water to recede. And he told the earth to open up. And that's why we got these continents now. Because in the days of Pele, the Bible tells me that the land separated. That's why we got North America. South America, Antarctica, Europe, y'all now listen to me, Africa, this is why we got a separation of the land, because the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit, hold over the water, and God said, let that be light, I will recreate the earth, hallelujah, I'm going to do it over again, God is telling us the same thing, I want to do you all over again. I'm only here to tell you, the man that was dealing with the drugs and dealing with all of this that he had, God was able to help him to overcome. Why? What made Seal want to do what he was doing? Because God called him. God ain't going to wait until you get delivered to call you. If that be the case, none of us. Hear the words of the Lord. If God waited for you were delivered, you would never come to church. You would never serve the Lord. I would never preach if I waited until I get right. You can't get right by yourself. You're already right through Jesus Christ, through his righteousness, through what he has done for me. I am who I am by the grace of God. I'm not going to quit. I'm not going to die. I'm not going to be discouraged. I shall overcome. And what's got me bound won't have me bound forever. Why? I see myself and God sees me. He already sees me delivered. He already sees me as a child. Next week. I'm so full right now, I'm about to blow up. But I can't give it to you all at one time. The Lord said, give you just enough. Hey, hallelujah. Give you just enough. Don't overdo it, son. I said, all right, Holy Ghost. The Holy Spirit will teach you if you want to be taught. If you want to listen. Anybody here want to listen? Anybody here want to hear? So who are you? You are a spirit. You possess what you feel, have knowledge, your mind, all that right there. You possess that. And you just so happen to live in the world. But who is the real you? Who is the real you? Who God want to communicate to? That's why you're able to understand me. And hear the words of the Lord and understand it. Now if you bring your dog and your cats in here and line them all up on the front pew. And I say, who is on the Lord's side? Let him come unto me. You know what your dog and cat going to do? They're going to look at the preacher and they're going to say, whoa, whoa, whoa. Unless I got some cat food and some dog food. They understand that. They'll move on their beauty. But other than that, they can understand the things of God. Only the ones who have a human spirit. Now, does a dog and a cat have a soul? I'm here to tell you. Yes, they do. How you know that, preacher? Because they can feel. They know whether you love them or not. Hello. My dog knew I didn't love him. He knew I liked him. He knew that. How he knew that? Because of the way I treated him. He knew my wife loved him. I just like it. I went and got it for my chair. Amen. But the way I took it to the poor dog, my thought about it, I ain't love him. I ain't gonna tell you, they ain't gonna lie to you. I ain't love the dog. Did I love him to the frill? And he knew it. He was doing me like I was crazy. All the time. I wait till he get to the deep sleep and I'll. Poor fucker looked at me like, man, you ain't got it all. Something wrong with you. But he always went. When he got ready to go to sleep, he went to sleep by Sister Frida, my wife. Because he knew he could have peace. And she was going. When he got ready to eat, I put it. I don't know, y'all been commenting to say, I ain't going to say all everything. Some of y'all think I'm going to be like, football player that they got in trouble with the dogs. Y'all can put me with Michael B. Glory to God, so I'm going to shut it off right now. Thank me and God. God wants you. Give him all of you. Work on it. And after a while, what you're going through, what's been nagging you, holding your back, he'll give you what you need. He'll come. Thank him for the preacher. Amen. Who was hooked up on drugs. Ray Charles was hooked up on. He said the first time they gave it to him, the man told him he was going to take it to a place that. Y'all heard God, y'all saw the movie? And the man before he started, the man told him, you don't want to. Then his girlfriend said, give me some of that, Ray. No, I don't give you nothing. I'm just going to take it to a place you don't want to go.
They're going to leave us today more energized.